we've come from far and wide this morning to lift your name in praise. Lord, we just ask for your presence this morning, that you anoint each and everyone here today on this high Sabbath with your Holy Spirit. Lord, touch each one of us personally today. Help us to take the things of this world that have distracted us all week, Lord, and just throw those things away, to cast our eyes upon you and fix them there. We ask and pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Good morning. Good morning. Happy Sabbath. A nice full church we have. This is awesome. So we have several announcements. First, we'll do our second reading. We have a second reading for transfer membership for Linda, Jim, and Brock Vanek from West County SDA to Mid Rivers SDA Church. We are not ashamed to steal the sheep. So this is where we actually do a vote. So do we have a motion? Do we have a second? Any opposed? All right, motion carried. All right, I'll come get your tithe check. All right, we also, we're looking forward to having a new Bible worker family coming in here soon. They were gonna visit this week, but things didn't work out. So we'll be seeing them soon. Now this is a husband and wife team, and they will be looking for a place to stay if possible, because they're only gonna be here a short time. As most of you probably know, it's hard to get a short lease or anything. So if there's a family out there that'd be willing to host the husband and wife, we're not expecting you to provide the meals and things like that, but they just need a safe place to be able to lay their heads down and do the Lord's work. There's a wedding shower here tomorrow for the Tan family, right? Got one leave on their way here. All right. That's exciting. So Emily's getting married. I didn't even know she had a boyfriend. So until she's getting married, so I'm not sure how I feel about that. Again, we have regular potluck. The Survival Man Camp is coming up here in Camp Heritage, April 19th through the 21st. And it says more info to follow. Do we have that info? Is there info? For Man Camp, yeah.
Just go to the conference website.
So the conference website? All right. Okay, and then Wacky Warriors on Sunday, 4/21. Of course, that's with the youth. And they need RSV by that, by 4/17. All these are in your bulletin, too, by the way. Baby shower for Michael and Imbule Corden. That's going to be, is that 2 weeks from now? And then there's a barbecue picnic at Creevecourt Park on June 1st at the Taco Bell Shelter. And, of course, we have VBS coming up in July 15th through the 19th. And I hope you can attend the Wednesday night Bible study. We get a good group here. It's been a blessing. We're studying out of the book of John. And then also, Louisa has had the opportunity to go and minister to one of the retirement homes in the area. And I'm not sure which one it is, but we're looking for some volunteers. We need a group of maybe 4 to 6 people that could anywhere from 1 to 2 a month be able to commit to that time to go minister to the people in the home. So, please feel free to see Louisa or the pastor to let them know that you're interested in doing that. So again, we're looking for a group of 4 to 6 people. It can be more, but it's a commitment of time. And also, Pastor, you have an announcement?
So friends, we had a just wonderful health class here just a few Sundays ago where we learned how to make healthy bread. And if you missed that, you missed out. But we do have another class coming up on May 26th, right? Is it May? Yeah, May 26th. And I'd like to share with you something this morning. Tori, would you just come on up with us? Just a little testimony of kind of what you missed last week and then help motivate you to come to the next health class.
Good morning. So we had our health ministry did our lunch for us a few weeks back. Time goes by quickly, so it could be months, but it we'll say weeks. And I tried some amazing bread, and I was like, who made this bread? And I tend to seek out and find the answers to my questions. So I found the answer to my question, and it was Alicia Harris. She made the bread. And it was the best bread I've ever had in my life. And so I love bread. I got to ask her for the recipe. She sent me the recipe. And I ordered a bread maker because I'm a cheater. Didn't realize they actually made the bread. They do fully. Just dump it in and out it comes. And hallelujah to me. So I started making the bread and my family absolutely loved it. And which is a huge blessing because this bread doesn't have sugar in it. It doesn't have eggs in it. It doesn't have oil. Right. Like, I'm like, okay. But my family absolutely loved it. And we are trying to eat a little healthier, but we didn't plan on eating that healthy. But it's made with ancient grains. And the more that you learn about the ancient grains, like spelt and einkorn and stuff, it is really interesting and extremely nutritious. So I had one of our young friends come to our house, and he tried the bread. He's about 20. And he's like, oh, this is so good. And I told him all about it, right, because it's so cool. And so he went home and ordered a bread maker and made the bread. And so he's in Iowa, a little bread maker at 20 years old. But please, don't forget about these health cooking classes. It's really extremely important that we improve our health, because if we're not healthy, then we can't really serve the Lord at the best capacity that we can. So we're all taking baby steps to do better and to feel better. And just pay attention to the bulletin. And please support our health ministry. It's important.
So no oil and ancient grains. It sounds like Wonder Bread, but only better. Come on. We have one more announcement.
Happy Sabbath. Okay, so next Sunday we're having our Wacky Warriors paintball event. It's at 10 a.m. at the Wentzville location, and the church will be paying for the kids, but the adults have to pay for their own. And all kids under 18 need a waiver, so I'll be passing around this sign-up sheet, and you'll just write your name, and make sure you write down all your contact information so that we can send you the waiver so that you can sign it. And all the little kids, they can still play, but they need to be accompanied by an adult. And please make sure you RSVP by April 17th, that's a Wednesday, to Zoo or Connie to make sure that you can go and have it all paid for. And I'll be passing this around, and that should be it. Thank you.
Thank you. Good job, Emily. Yeah. Goodbye, our praise team up.
Wow, this is, we're only singing one song because it's a very, very full Sabbath, but the odds that it's going to sound fantastic are really with you guys. This is going to be good, right? We won't have to sing at all. They're going to sing. So, sing.
Oh. Happy Sabbath, children. And thank you. And I need help from you children today with the children's story. Okay, we're going to talk about the word. It's spelled G-O. Who can say that? G-O. And what does it say? Go. Go, yes. And that's an action word. That's something that you have to do. And I'm going to speak to you about a word said come. Yes, come. That's actually an invitation. And it's actually an action word too. So, God wants me to tell you children to go to Him at all times. Go to Him when you're happy. Go to Him with news. Go to Him if you need someone to talk to. Go to Him if you make a mistake. Go to Him if you need the answer. Go to Him when you sin. Go to you when you sin. God loves you. I'm going to tell you about one of the times I had to go to God in the last 3 years. I needed big help. I made a big mistake. I had an eye doctor appointment. And for some reason, I had to drive my husband's truck, which was in the garage. So I backed out of the garage, and I don't know how I did it, but with the driver's front side, I ran into the garage, the roller part of the garage. I mangled the roller part. The garage couldn't be shut, and I put a dent in the driver's front driver's side. So I was out of the driveway, and my neighbor was outside, and I said, I ran into my garage. I got to go to the eye doctor, so she watched for me, but I'm talking to God. I said, God, this isn't good. My husband's not going to be happy with me. So I went to the eye doctor, and guess what? I got a good report. I didn't even have to wear glasses when I drive anymore. That restriction was taken off. It was sort of funny. Well, so what happened is I get home and my neighbor had looked up three numbers for garage door opener people. And it was during the COVID season, so I called the first two. They were booked and they didn't have parts. And so I called the third number and the man said, I'm booked till July. And so he said, where do you live? I'm praying and I'm praying and I'm praying. And I said, I live in Winfield. He said, oh, my father lives in Winfield. He says, I'll come to your house. So he came out to my house and he looked at it. He said, I think I put this garage door in your house, which is a miracle. So then he says to me, he looks at that roller part, which is mangled. He says, I think I have that part in my vehicle. So he goes to his vehicle and he has that part. Now, guess what about this? I was praying that it would be done before my husband came home, but it wasn't. My husband got home, but right after he pulled in the driveway, guess who pulled in front of the house? The man that fixed my garage. So I was praying and praying and praying, and you know what? God answered that prayer. I didn't have to come to Him. That garage door would not have been fixed. So, go to God for everything. Everything in your life, especially when you sin, when you need help. He never tires of us. And does God tell us to come? He tells us to come. Always come when He calls you. And last but not least, God wanted me to say this. Did God tell us in Matthew 28 anything to do? Did God tell us anything to do which goes with go in Matthew 28?
Go tell the word or the gospel.
That's right. He said to go tell the gospel to all the world. And so that's the end of our story. And so remember to always go to God for anything. And now you can go pick up the offering. Amen.
time for our offering this morning. And the offering today is for Hope Channel International. The impact of Hope Channel is evident in the inspiring stories of God's children, like Pastor Ross and baby Aurora. Pastor Ross overcame drug addiction to become an ordained Seventh-day Adventist pastor after discovering Hope Sabbath School. Following baby Aurora's brachial plexus injury at birth, she was miraculously healed thanks to our most watched Let's Pray program and prayers on her behalf from our global community. With your offering today, Hope Channel can continue to share the transformational love of Jesus Christ with people all over the world by producing high-quality Christian content to reach new audiences in innovative ways. Our Hope Study platform is online and offers Bible studies on a range of topics. So far, over 300,000 people started taking these courses just 1 year after the platform went live. People are hungering for Bible truth. As we read in Proverbs 11:25, whoever brings blessing will be enriched, and one who waters will himself be watered. By faithfully supporting Hope Channel International, you are not only blessing others, but yourself as well, by bringing hope to those who need it most, and by telling them of the love of Jesus Christ. After celebrating 20 years of Hope Channel and reaching over 80 countries with the Advent message, let's make 2024 the most impactful year yet in sharing hope in Jesus and with people everywhere. Give hope through your offering today. We can ask for our deacons to come forward. Let's pray. Our Father in heaven, we ask for your blessing to be upon our tithes and offerings, that you will bless the givers and the receivers. And we thank you for this. In Jesus' name, amen.
Have a special treat today. You know, in our Sabbath School quarterlies, we have memory verses. We're supposed to memorize them. I don't want to show off, so I'm going to let Edna do it. Edna has a sound mind and no school like old school. Edna, to be able to do that is amazing.
morning, children and friends. Happy Sabbath. Well, I'm here to repeat the memory verses of last quarter, or to know that I cannot do it of myself. Amen. I can do all things with Christ, strengthened me. And it is important that we study the word and hide them in our hearts, that when the Bible is taken from us, we can be able to prove who we are as Seventh-day Adventists, to tell who we serve, and to know the Lord, and to be ready to meet him. So this is my desire. So I'm asking you to pray for me, because, you know, the brain sometimes not what it used to be. But as I've said already, I can do all things with Christ who strengthened me. So let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your most glorious name. We are thanking thee for your love and your mercy. Help us to be on the alert at all times, to defend the cause, to prove we are a Seventh-day Adventist, that when the times come, dear Lord, that we don't have the Bible, the Holy Spirit will bring the things to our memory that will tell of thee, who we serve, why we serve you, so that you can take us home with you, is my prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. The lesson for the last quarter is Psalms. Lesson 1, January 6th. How to read the Psalms. And he said unto them, these are the words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that all things must be fulfilled which are written in the laws of Moses and in the prophets and in Psalms concerning me. Then open ye their understanding that they might comprehend the scripture. Luke 24:44-45. Lesson 2. January 13, teach us how to pray. And it came to pass, while he was praying in a certain place, when he ceased, one of his disciples came and said, Lord, teach us to pray, as John taught his disciples. Luke 11:1. Lesson 3, January 20. The Lord reigns. The Lord reigns. He is robed in majesty. The Lord is robed with majesty and armed with strength. Indeed, the world is established in the Lord is established in liberty, truth, and love. Psalms 93:1. Lesson 4. The Lord saves and delivers. The righteous cry. The Lord hears and delivers them out of all their troubles. Psalms 34:17. Lesson 4. Lesson 5. How can I sing the Lord's song in a strange land? Singing the Lord's song in a strange land. How can I sing the Lord in a strange land? Psalm 137:4. Lesson 6. February, I will arise. Then he said, I will arise and set them in the place. Then said the Lord, I will arise, said thee, and set them in the place for which they yearns. Psalms 57, 9 and 10. Lesson 7, February 17. His Majesty, His Majesty, just bear with me, baby. The righteous cry, and the Lord hears and delivers them out of all their troubles. Lesson 6. Lesson 7, the Lord reigns. I will praise the Lord. I will sing praise to the Lord. I will praise the Lord among the peoples. I will sing among all nations, for the Lord's I will praise the Lord among the people. I will sing to the Lord among the nations, for the Lord. For your mercy reaches to the heavens. Psalms 57, 10 and 11. Lesson 8, wisdom for righteous living. Wisdom for righteous living. Wisdom for righteous living. So teach us no more days, that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom. Amen. Psalms 90, verse 12. Lesson 9. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Amen. The stone that the builder rejects becomes a chief cornerstone. This is the Lord's doing and is marvelous in our eyes. Psalms 118, 22 and 23. Lesson 9. March 2. I think it's lesson 10. March 9. Lessons from the past. We have heard and known, and our fathers have told us, we will not hide it from their children, telling it to the generations to come, the mercies of the Lord and his wonderful works which he has done. Psalms 78, 3 and 4. Lesson 9, March 2. Sing, longing for God in Zion. My heart, my soul longs, yea, even thirsts for the living God. my heart and my flesh cry out to the living God. Psalms 84:2. Lesson 12. March 24. Prayers. Worship that never ends. I will sing. I will praise the Lord as long as I live. I will say praise to the Lord as long as I have life. Psalms 104, verse 33. Lesson 13. March 30. Lesson 30, March 30.
Wait on the Lord.
Wait on the Lord. Be of good courage, and he shall strengthen thine heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord. Psalms 27, verse 14.
Beloved, I only hope that at 102, I can recite God's word the same way. Amen. 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 Let's all now please stand for holy ground.
If you have a burden and you would like to come up front, I invite you to please come up front as we pray. If you have a burden in your heart, please feel free to come to the altar. Our eyes are closed. Our Father in heaven, we come to you, Lord. One more time, God, you have given us an opportunity to seek your face. Lord, we have not done anything special this morning. We have not done anything special this week for us to be able to have this opportunity to come and seek your face. Before we say anything, Lord, you who can tend to the entire forest at the same time and tend to the individual trees at the same time, Lord, we are asking that you forgive us of our sins. Father, I am praying for myself right now, and I'm asking, Lord, that you forgive me of my sins. Lord, may you hear our cry. Lord, we are not just asking for forgiveness of sins, but we are asking that you create in us a new heart, Lord. Give us a heart of flesh, Lord, and rid those habits of sin from our lives. Lord, we are praying that you cover this church at this point in time. Lord, we are asking that you visit the very youngest child in this church to the very oldest child in this church, Lord. And we are asking that may your church be built on truth and truth alone, Father. May we engage as a church in the concept of studying your word. We are praying as we listen to the words that your servant has for us today, Father. May you cover him. Lord, I'm asking that you touch his lips, touch his mind, Lord, and may he give us what you want him to say and not what he thinks of you, but what you reveal to him, Father. I'm praying and I'm asking God today that as we engage and celebrate the baptism of our sister Katie today, Lord, we are asking that you walk with her. Walk with her day by day, and not just her alone. We have many people in this church who are in the valley of decision making. Lord, I pray and I ask that may you give them the strength to give their lives to you. Father, we are praying that as we leave this place, we might leave this place as changed people. We might leave this place as people who are ready to share your gospel. We thank you, Lord, for hearing our cry. We thank you, Lord, for hearing our petition. And someone right now is going through something difficult. May you meet them at their point of need, Father. And may you send deliverance their way. In Jesus' name we pray. May the church of God please say amen.
Good morning, church. Happy Sabbath. You know, when I asked our sister to do the scripture reading this morning, I did not realize that she was going to go through all 13 lessons of this month's quarterly. At 102. I can't remember the memory verse from one week to the next. Lord, help us. Lord, help us. Beloved, we have a lot to cover today. And so if you don't mind, I'm just going to jump right into the message. Today's message is called Revelation's Reward. And forgive me for just a second, I forgot my clicker. Bear with me. A lack of memory. Now you know I wasn't joking. There we go. Before we jump into God's word, what do we do? Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, Father, we know that you are with us today. Lord, we know because there's a baptism today that all of heaven is with us today. The angels' eyes are watching as we prepare to anoint another person into your kingdom. So, Lord, we just ask for a very special blessing today. We know that you're with us already, but we just ask that you speak to us, Lord, that you move our hearts, and that you help those that are struggling with whatever they're struggling with today to leave here knowing, yes, you are with us. And Lord, if you are with us, who can be against us? And so, Lord, we just ask again for your anointing of the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Church, have you ever said, or maybe you've heard someone say, I thought I had died and gone to heaven, right? Or maybe this one, that's a match made in heaven. Or heaven forbid. Or maybe this one, it's heaven on earth, right? So obviously some of you have heard or used some of these expressions before. And recently there was a survey conducted asking people from all ages and all classes of society this one simple question. What do you think heaven is like? And here are just a few of their responses. This is from a teenager. She said, heaven? That's totally pie in the sky. I mean, that's out there somewhere, unreal. I can't fathom it. A middle-aged woman. Heaven is a state of mind. It's an inner peace. It's a state of calm. Then a successful businessman was asked, what do you think heaven is like? And he said, heaven is my house. It's worth $3 million. My chariot is my Jag, and the angels are my kids. A college student was asked, what do you think heaven is like? And he replied, are you so out of touch that you still believe in those fairy tales? An elderly couple was asked. They said, we hope heaven is a real place. The older we get, the more we long for it. We just hope that what we were taught as children is true. So many people, yet so many different answers. There's all this confusion out there over a very simple question. What is heaven really like? So that's what we're going to find out this morning. What is heaven really like? Now tell me, church, help me out this morning. Where can we find the valid information that we need about heaven? Where can we find that? We find it in the Bible, right? Now the key to unlock the mystery of heaven is found where, church? In the Bible. And so I want to share a concept with you that I've heard and that my family and I really, we try to live by. This is a concept that I know many of you have heard, but maybe some of you haven't. Are you ready for this? Here's the concept. If it's in the Bible, I believe it. If it disagrees with the Bible, it's not for me. Let me say that again. If it's in the Bible, I believe it. If it disagrees with the Bible, it's not for me. Now, the Bible says in Revelation 21 and verse 1, and I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. Now, beloved, each of the prophets from Genesis to Revelation are pointing men and women on this planet towards a new heaven and a new earth. They're pointing us forward
so that we can know what is to come. The new heaven and the new earth is a place beyond our imagination. Now, I want to show you something this morning. Turn with me in your Bibles to 1 Corinthians, 1 Corinthians chapter 2 and verse 9. Now, we're talking here about the glory that is awaiting us in heaven, and the Bible declares something that is absolutely amazing in 1 Corinthians chapter 2 and verse 9. It starts out by saying, "But as it is written, the eye has not seen, the ear has not heard, nor have entered into the heart of man the things which God has prepared for those who love him." What a promise. It is written. Paul is actually quoting from Isaiah chapter 64, verses 4 and 5. He's relaying a promise to those who rejoice in God's ways and worketh righteousness. These are people that are living out their lives the way God has asked them to live. Now help me, church. Jesus tells me, if you love me, you will keep my what? Paul is quoting Isaiah 64, or Paul in quoting Isaiah 64, he's picking up on this same theme, and he says, God has something so special, God has something so incredible, so amazing that words cannot fully describe it. No one has ever seen anything like it. The sounds of heaven by themselves are beyond anything you've ever heard. You can't even fathom it. It's beyond your imagination. And it's waiting for everyone who loves God. Now, the key to those who want to unlock Revelation's reward is this simple principle. God has prepared a heaven for those who what, church? Church, say it like you believe it this morning. God has prepared heaven for those who what?
Love
him. Now, I want to pause here for just a moment. And I want to look at a question that I hear a lot about heaven. Maybe you've asked this yourself. If you've ever lost a pet, I know your children have asked. Will my pet... Will my beloved animal be in heaven with me? So let's look at what the Bible says together, shall we? Turn with me in your Bibles to Isaiah chapter 11 and verse 6. What book, church? Isaiah. What chapter did I say? And verse 6. Now, before we read this, do you remember our concept from earlier? If it's in the Bible, I believe it. If it disagrees with the Bible, it's not for me, right? Isaiah is describing what the kingdom of heaven is going to be like, and we see something pretty amazing in Isaiah chapter 11 and verse 6. Now, to set the time here, this is after the 1,000-year period where we are with God in heaven, and he has brought New Jerusalem now down to earth, and we have a new earth and a new heaven. That's the timeline that we're looking at. And the Bible says in Isaiah chapter 11 and verse 6, the wolf, the what, church? The wolf will live with the lamb, and the leopard will lie down with the goat. The calf and the young lion and fatling will be together, and a little child will lead them. Now let's pause here for just a quick moment. According to the scripture that we just read together, will there be dogs in heaven? Well, the Bible says that a wolf will live with the lamb. So yes, there will be dogs in heaven because a wolf is a breed of dog, right? Now let's keep reading. The leopard will lie down with the goat. Well, a leopard is a form of cat. So will there be cats in heaven? Right? Yes, it appears so. Or at least on the new earth. And who is leading these animals and playing with them? A little child. What is this? There will be children in heaven? Well, that's what the Bible says, right? Let's keep reading. Verse 8. The infant will play by the cobra den, and the toddler will reach into the viper's nest. They will neither harm nor destroy in all my holy mountain. Little children, infants, toddlers. Friends, place a ribbon here. We're gonna come back to this in just a moment, but I want to show you something in Revelation chapter 21 and verse 4. Let's turn there together. Revelation chapter 21 and verse 4. Again, we're talking about heaven. Revelation 21, what verse, church? Verse 4. The Bible says, God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. There shall be no more death, nor sorrow, nor crying. There shall be no more pain, for the former things have passed away. Now, there's a lot here, brothers and sisters. The Bible says there will be no more tears, no more death. But I want you to notice that there will be no more sorrow or crying. Is that what your Bible says? Yes or no? Beloved, I want to share a true story with you this morning. A few years ago, a couple, their names were the Hendersons, they received devastating news that their 13-year-old daughter, their little girl, was diagnosed with a rare form of cancer that very few people survive from. Now, unwilling to give up, the Hendersons went to doctor after doctor, from hospital to hospital, from specialist to specialist, until they finally settled on a treatment plan. Meanwhile, the entire community rallied around them. You couldn't drive anywhere in their hometown or the surrounding towns or the surrounding communities without seeing a Pray for Macy bumper sticker or a yellow ribbon tied around someone's tree. On September 24th, 2015, just 3 weeks after her diagnosis, Macy fell asleep in the Lord. Now, friends, let's reason together for just a moment. The Bible says that there will be no more sorrow in heaven. So let me ask you, what is the opposite of sorrow? Joy. The Bible says that there will be animals in heaven, and little children will lead them. And then in verse 8, the Bible gives us even more detail. It tells us that there will be infants and toddlers in heaven. So what does this mean? Think about it, church. It means that every infant lost in the womb, that every toddler that sleeps in the grave, that even little children have a place in heaven. It means that we will be made whole, that the sorrow that a grieving mother experiences will be turned into joy as she holds her lost baby again. And even if, heaven forbid, some mothers choose a different path and they choose not to follow Christ, it means that God's people, you and I, some of us that can't have children, we will get to raise these children. God didn't say no to healing Macy. He said, not yet. He said, I have something better for her. You see, Macy is going to get to grow up in a world without pain, without death, without crying, without sorrow. Macy is going to get a new body, one free from sickness and sin. She will know joy beyond the limits of anything we can imagine. So what's heaven going to be like? Well, one thing that we know for sure is that it will be joyful, because sorrow will no longer exist. There will be no more crying. There will be no more pain. there will be no more death. Heaven is filled with animals, and it's filled with children. Amen? Verse after verse, the Bible is full of details about heaven. The length, the height, the width of New Jerusalem, God's heavenly city. The city itself, how it's made with pure gold likened to clear glass. The foundation stones of the city and how they are built with a great wall surrounding the city and all manners of precious stones in that wall like a rainbow. And set within the wall, 12 gates made of solid pearl. I mean, you think about how we can't even imagine this. Do you know how a pearl is made? It's like grit gets in the little clam and it becomes irritation, and over time it grows and grows and grows. Can you imagine the size of the clam it would take to make a gate a pearl? Or will God just speak it into existence? The river of life will flow from the very throne of God out of the city. And on either side of the river will be the tree of life. The river will literally split the tree. But how do we obtain this heavenly reward that's found in Revelation? The answer is actually a simple one. We read it earlier in 1 Corinthians 2:9 that God has prepared it for those who love him. But in Revelation 21, verses 6 and 7, we see some more detail. It says, I will give of the foundation of the water of life freely to him who thirsts, or fountain of the water of life freely to him who thirsts. He who overcomes shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son. She shall be my daughter. John says that if you thirst after the water of life, if you thirst after God, the living water, he will give you himself freely. John then goes on to tell us what that would look like when he says, when we've partaken of the water of life, the Bible says, he that overcomes shall what, church? He that overcomes shall what? And I will be his God, and he shall be my son. You see, beloved, Jesus loves you too much to pay your ransom and then leave you a slave to sin. He didn't endure the cross just to leave you in chains. He didn't take that beating so that we could just keep on cheating. Let me show you something. I want to make sure that you're not missing this morning. Turn with me in your Bibles to John chapter 7. John, the Gospel of John, chapter 7. Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, chapter 7. Jesus was talking with the disciples, and he had just told them that he was going to be leaving soon and that they are going to seek him, but where he is going, they cannot go. Now, this caused a stir, and you can imagine it would. This caused a stir among the disciples, and they started talking amongst themselves, trying to understand what this meant. Now, let's pick up the story here in verse 37, John 7, 37. On the last day of the great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried out, saying, if anyone thirsts. If anyone what, church? If anyone thirsts, let him come to me and drink. He who believes in me, as the scripture has said, out of his hearts will flow rivers of living water. Notice this now. This is important. Don't miss this, church. Where is present tense? Where is the living water flowing from? It's flowing out of you. Everyone who drinks of the living water becomes a fountain of life. Now, you're not the source, But the living water that God has given you is now flowing out of you. Just like you can't hold back a river, you cannot contain the river of living water. The Holy Spirit that is living in you is now your base of operation. You flow out, or it flows out of you into your neighbors. It flows out of you into your loved ones. It flows out of you into your coworkers. You are now a missionary to God's world, a missionary to the gospel. And because you now have the water of life, because you now have the Holy Spirit living in you, the same power that rose Jesus from the grave, now dwelling in your heart, you are now being transformed into a new creature, an overcomer, one who is repulsed by sin. Amen. And those who have overcome shall what, church? Think about it this way. The inheritance of your Uncle Louis is greater than you can imagine. And your Uncle Louis, he wants you to have everything that he has to give you. Will you accept that inheritance, or will you deny it? Because Louis's already got you, the will's written. And he just needs to fill in your name. God has a book too. It's called the Book of Life. And if your name is written in it, then you are an inheritor. And if you love God, if you overcome these things in your life that God doesn't want you to indulge in, then you are an inheritor. God says, if you ask me, I will give you the water of life freely. He says, I came to this earth so that you could have it. I endured so that you could be set free. Now, there's one more thing that I want to share with you today. About heaven, God's intention, his great desire, is to dwell in the midst of his people for all eternity. Well, how do you know that, Pastor? Revelation 21, verse 3. Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and he shall be their people. The word of God, the Bible says, God himself will be with them and be their God. Beloved, the Bible is not silent about heaven. What will heaven be like? Words can't describe the glory, but God himself will dwell with us. In heaven, God's kingdom is a place I long to be. How about you, church? Now, speaking of heaven, some of you might not have been aware of it before you came to church this morning, but today is a very special day. It's a high Sabbath. Today we have the privilege to rejoice with the hosts of heavens, to rejoice in the very presence of God, because today, in just a few moments, in fact, we'll be having the privilege to witness a sister enter into the kingdom of heaven. We'll have her name written in the Lamb's Book of Life, maybe I should say that. We get to witness her lay claim to her heavenly birth certificate. As she says no to self and is born again in God's heavenly kingdom. Now, at this time, I'd like to ask Katie. Katie, I don't know where you're sitting, but if you would you come on up? Katie. Oh, there she is. Hayden, come on up. Stand right here. We'll need this mic for you here. Go ahead and turn this on. Now, brothers and sisters, Katie was baptized at age 14. She's not 14 anymore. And as she'll share with us here in a little bit, some things have happened and transpired in her life, and she is wanting to recommit herself to the Lord. And so, because Katie is already a member of the church, because she's already been baptized, I want to do something a little bit different today. Normally, we go through baptismal vows, and we ask Katie to agree to these things as a witness to the church and as a witness before God. But today, since she is already a member, what we're going to do is I'm just going to ask Katie a few simple questions to serve as this witness, right? And Katie, you're just going to say yes or no to each question. Number one, do you accept Jesus Christ as your personal Savior and Lord, and do you desire to live your life in a saving relationship with Him?
I do.
Amen. Do you accept the teachings of the Bible as expressed in the Statement of Foundational Beliefs of the Seventh-day Adventist Church? And do you pledge by God's grace to live your life in harmony with these teachings?
I do.
And finally, Katie, do you desire to be baptized as a public expression of your belief in Jesus Christ, to be accepted into the fellowship of the Seventh-day Adventist Church, and to support the church and its mission as a faithful steward of your personal influence, tithes, and offerings, and a life of service?
I do.
Amen. Church, as Katie and I are preparing for baptism, we just have some special music from Called by Christ.
Turn our hymnals to 318. surrender.
Years. has been struggling to follow after Christ and not follow the world. There's been trials and tribulations, and the devil has done everything he can to rip her down. And during this time, especially over the last few months, there was a very special song that Katie heard on the radio, and it just helped her to keep her eyes cast on the Lord. And Katie would like you to hear that song now. What's it called, Katie?
You Can Rest by Hillary Scott.
You Can Rest.
Jesus.
the shotgun mic pick up, Katie? Somebody bring me a handheld. There we go. So, brothers and sisters, before we commence with Katie's baptism, I just want to give Katie an opportunity to talk to us a little bit about what has brought her to this valley of decision. Take your time.
I've been struggling for the past few years. I've done some stuff in the past that I regret. But I changed. Amen. And I've been doing Bible studies with Tori Clark for the past 8 months, and I could tell that God has been working on me in those 8 months. I've changed so much, and I am so happy. I wouldn't be here today if it wasn't for the Bible studies and the constant prayers from my friends and family, and for God's grace and love.
Beloved, this church family has welcomed Katie into their lives. And I know that Katie just shared that, yeah, she's been studying with Tori and that meant a lot to her. But you have kept her covered in prayer. And that means everything. You know, there's a saying, and I say a lot, maybe you've heard me say it, maybe you haven't. It's kind of cliche, but it's true. Maybe you could even finish it for me. More prayer, more power. Amen. And so God has brought Katie to a point in her life where she wishes to surrender her life to Him and rededicate her life to Him to live for Jesus. And that's what I hope something, if you haven't made that commitment in your life already, I hope that you will make that commitment as well. And with that being said, step forward just a little bit. There we go. Katie, it is my great privilege and honor, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, to baptize you.
It is really a joyous occasion, church. We are going to continue with our singing, and we are going to sing 4-3-2. Shall we gather at the river? 4-3-2. Now, if I don't see you singing, I'm going to have you come and sing up here by yourself. 4-3-2.
Forever, calling by the throne of God.
special song that we're going to sing. So, if I were to take our grandparents and we would ask them to sing this song, they would probably sing this song in this manner. One, two, three, take.
What a fellowship, what a joy divinely leaning on the everlasting arms. What a blessedness, what a peace is mine leaning on the everlasting arms.
But I think if the chosen generation sang it, this is how it would sound like.
Oh, how sweet to walk in this pilgrim way, leaning on the everlasting arms. Oh, how bright the path grows from day to day, leaning on the everlasting arms. Leaning on Jesus Christ, my Savior, safe and secure from all alarms. Leaning on Jesus Christ, my Savior, leaning on the everlasting arms. What have I to dread? What have I to fear? Leaning on the everlasting arms. I have blessedness with my Lord so near. Leaning on the everlasting arms. Leaning on Jesus Christ, my Savior, safe and secure from all alarms. Leaning on Jesus Christ, my Savior, leaning on the everlasting arms. Leaning on Jesus Christ, my Savior, safe and secure from all alarms. Leaning on Jesus Christ, my Savior, leaning on the everlasting arms. 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 Leaning on the everlasting arms.
Beloved, I misspoke earlier. I called our group there, called by Christ. It's called by God. And by the way, if you would like them to sing at your church, that can be arranged, but their manager is the big guy upstairs. So if you want to get a hold of them, just start praying. God will work it out. Amen? Or you can contact Lou. Beloved, before we close the service today, I just would like to invite the elders and Katie, would you come back up, please? And the elders of this church, and will somebody hand me that bag right there? Yes, ma'am. Thank you so much. Come on up, and let's just surround Katie here. Katie, this is a gift from the church. It is your birth certificate from today and your a dedication book and a very special gift that I'll leave as a surprise when you open it. Now, church, normally we're calling for a vote of membership right now. We don't need to do that. Katie's rededicating her life to the Lord. And so instead, we just want to take this time to pray a very special prayer of dedication and ask God to hold on to Katie. All right? Will you join us in prayer? Gentlemen, just lay your hands on her. Heavenly Father, Father, we know that the enemy has done everything in his power to take Katie. But Lord, you say that if you have started a work in us, you will finish it. Lord, you say you will never leave us or forsake us. And we know from your word that if we are yours, there is nothing that can separate us from you. And so, Lord, we just ask for a very special anointing upon Katie. Lord, we know that at some point in her life when she was young, she backslid. And Lord, many of us have made bad decisions in our lives. Many of us have turned our eyes away from you. But Lord, Katie has purposed in her heart to set her eyes on you once again. And no matter how hard life can be, no matter the struggles that come before, no matter the obstacles that Satan tries to set, no matter the snares that he lays out, Lord, she will keep her eyes fixed on you. And Lord, we know that where you lead, all we have to do is follow you, and we will be okay. So Lord, we ask for again that special anointing of the Holy Spirit upon her. Let anything that's in her life now that is not pleasing to you be done away with. Let her get victory, Lord. And as she looks to you, as she opens her heart to you, we know that she will overcome because you are dwelling in her. So, Lord, we ask and we pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Thank you, gentlemen. Will you lead us out with Zion?
We are going to have our final song, Marching to Zion.
Sorry.
Father, dismiss us with your love until we meet again next Sabbath. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you.